Hey, today I'm going to be talking about something we all do, or at least try to do. What I'm talking about is sleep. We all know that sleep is really important. I'm sure we've all heard someone tell us that teens should get 8 to 9 hours of sleep, or adults should get 7 to 9 hours of sleep. But why exactly do we need sleep? And why do scientists recommend these specific amounts of sleep? To answer these questions, I'm going to be talking about what exactly makes up sleep, what occurs due to a lack of sleep, what environmental factors prevent us from getting sleep, and how to maximize sleep so that all of us can do our absolute best in our academics, career, and day-to-day life. First of all, sleep is incredibly important to memory, attention, repair, and proper brain function. But what exactly makes up sleep? Well, there are 5 stages of sleep. 4 of these stages of sleep are non-REM sleep, or sleep without rapid eye movement. Of the 4 stages of non-REM sleep, stage 3 and stage 4 are part of deep sleep, which is a crucial type of sleep for the body. Deep sleep helps the brain create and store new memories and improves its ability to collect and recall information. Therefore, to answer our question from earlier, scientists recommend various hours of sleep based on if the length of sleep will allow the body plenty of time in the deeper stages. Furthermore, when individuals receive adequate amounts of deep sleep, their bodily chemicals are able to replenish and restore. For example, glucose is replenished and hormones are balanced during these stages, specifically the human growth hormone, which helps tissues in the body grow and regenerate cells. But lack of deep sleep can cause many problems, such as hormone imbalances, lack of growth and regeneration of cells, as well as difficulty retaining information or making new memories. There has also been an association between long-term issues with deep sleep and other conditions such as heart disease or Alzheimer's disease. Hence, deep sleep is crucial to both short-term and long-term health. Along with deep sleep, REM sleep, or the 5th stage, is another form of sleep that is crucial to human functioning. REM sleep occurs when we move backwards through the stages, as well as increases in length with every cycle. The REM stage occurs about 90 minutes after falling asleep. Additionally, this stage is also when most dreaming occurs. Lack of REM sleep can also lead to several problems, especially deficits in attention. During REM sleep, a neurotransmitter known as norepinephrine is replenished, which allows you to pay attention. Your norepinephrine supply depletes when it is used up to pay attention throughout the day. Upon sleeping and entering REM sleep, it replenishes. Lack of REM sleep therefore indicates that the norepinephrine used up from the day does not have a chance to restore, which then leads to difficulty paying attention the next day. This lack of focus can be incredibly harmful to a student's grades and dangerous in situations such as driving and night shift work. In fact, half of all night shift workers, such as airplane pilots, physicians, and nurses, regularly report nodding off at work. I wouldn't want to be on that plane. Since sleep is really important for academics and all careers, it is important to understand what environmental factors affect sleep. The first factor is light. In the retina of the eye, light-sensitive cells influence our internal clock by informing the brain of whether it is day or night based on whether or not they see light. The brain then uses this information to set up our sleep patterns. This is also where our circadian rhythms or sleep-wake cycle come into play, since circadian rhythms dictate our internal clock based on light and other environmental factors. In our evolutionary history, once the sun set, our light-sensitive cells would inform the brain that it is night since there was no more light, and because there was no reason to stay awake, we would sleep. Now that we have electricity and cell phones, we continue to stay awake even after the sun sets. This affects our sleep pattern since exposure to light in the late evening tends to delay the phase of our internal clock and lead us to prefer later sleep times, as well as can cause our internal clock to reset, making it even more difficult to sleep. To combat this issue, if you don't like sleeping in complete darkness, nightlights in hallways and bathrooms are recommended. This makes sure that the light is far enough away where it doesn't disturb your sleep while still making sure that you can at least see what's in your room. Aside from light, there are other factors like noise and temperature that influence sleep. For example, the volume of background noises must be low to prevent an increased frequency of awakenings, which may prevent transitioning to deep sleep. In terms of temperature, you can just sleep in whatever temperature feels most comfortable since there is no set ideal temperature. However, extreme temperatures disrupt sleep, specifically REM sleep. In fact, extremely cold temperatures can deprive you of REM sleep entirely. I prefer sleeping in colder temperatures, but I definitely don't do well when it's too cold. The last factor I'm going to mention that adversely impacts sleep are substances like medications, alcohol, and coffee. Medications such as the antihistamines we use during allergy season and many prescription drugs used to treat common disease symptoms have been found to negatively impact sleep. Likewise, 2 or 3 drinks of alcohol is often used as a sleep aid, but after continued use for more than 3 days, alcohol compromises your quality of sleep by increasing awakenings and sometimes even leading to insomnia. Additionally, we know that caffeine has the ability to compromise our sleep since it is a stimulant, so try not to drink coffee unless it is 6 to 7 hours before bed. Since various factors clearly affect sleep, it is important to understand how to maximize sleep on top of any solutions listed earlier. Throughout the day, sun exposure can aid sleep as it assists your internal clock in maintaining a healthy sleep-wake cycle. To promote deep sleep, vigorous exercise early in the day and eating more healthful fats are recommended. Additionally, relaxing activities such as taking a bath or reading are helpful in winding down for a good night's rest. Avoiding blue lights from technology and big meals before sleeping can also help, as well as refraining from caffeine late in the day. If you can't fall asleep after 20 minutes, scientists encourage getting out of bed, going to another room, and doing something relaxing like reading or listening to music until you are tired enough to sleep. Although napping can decrease sleep drive, leading to difficulties falling asleep later on, a short 10 to 20 minutes rest before 5 p.m. can be beneficial by increasing relaxation, reaction time, and alertness, as well as by reducing fatigue. Napping can also improve mood, performance, and memory. Finally, trying to sleep at the same time every night with a set sleep schedule is very important and will help increase sleep efficiency. Ultimately, sleep is very important. By understanding why we need it and how we can get more of it, we can all function and excel in our daily activities. With the right tips and knowledge, everyone can experience the endless benefits of sleep. All we have to do is give healthy sleeping habits a try.